Hello, my name is awesome. How to create brand names that stick. Second edition. Written by Alexandra Watkins. Narrated by Claire Buchignani. To my awesome mom, Joan Casale, thank you for being there for every chapter of my life and every page of this book again. What's new, Pussycat? Since this book was first published in 2014, I've amassed enough news stories, eye-opening examples, and lucrative brainstorming sources to practically write a new book about brand names. That's what this 5th anniversary second edition feels like. More than 50% of the content here is brand spankin' new. Not new, as in I was too lazy to add anything of substance, so I regurgitated the old content and fattened up the pages with extraneous fluff. Nope. New, as in I was hell-bent on writing a bigger and better book because I had so much valuable new material to share and wanted to give you the Fort Knox of naming know-how. This is solid gold, baby. Here are just a few of the many updates. I've doubled the number of brainstorming tools and techniques, digging deeper into the hidden treasures of the online gold mine. You'll discover that it's never been easier to come up with loads of creative names quickly. My new list of 10 bonus brainstorming sources includes a little-known website where you'll discover more than 1,200 idea-inspiring name generators. You'll be surprised at what looking at mutant species names will spark. You'll find even more secrets and strategies to nab an available domain name. Not the verbal vomit that looks like someone got drunk and played Scrabble. You'll learn how to get a domain name that people can actually pronounce and spell. And I'll show you how to get great domain names without having to fork over big bucks. You'll be inspired by all the creative solutions people have come up with, including one for a turkey company that will make even vegans smile. I've made a significant modification to my 12-point name evaluation filter, the smile and scratch test. The M in smile, which formerly stood for meaningful, now stands for memorable. The importance of your name being meaningful is woven throughout the book. You'll learn how the names we are most likely to remember are associated with words and concepts we already know. I illustrate this with several amusing stories and personal anecdotes, including tales of a teetering tiki bar and my encounter with a surfer dude named Coconut Joel. Plus, you'll read about a name millions of us have exclaimed with glee. Hint, it kind of rhymes with macaroni and is just as much fun to say. This book tells so many cautionary tales of massive fails that it could have been titled, Hello, My Name is Bonehead. Wait until you read about the blunder Whole Foods made when they partnered with a restaurant in 2018. Perhaps you saw the news headline, Come for the racism, stay for the disease. Diseases run rampant throughout this book. I suppose I could have also titled the book, Hello, My Name is Infectious. The antidote to ill-fated names is, of course, awesome names, of which you will find plenty. In fact, one of them is the name Plenty. This vertical farming startup raised more than $200 million in funding after it changed its name from one that was holding it back. There's no holding back companies with some of the risque names you'll read about, including a nail salon in San Francisco with a name that would make your father blush. This new edition also covers B2B, business-to-business names. You'll soon rethink the common belief that business-to-business names can't have a sense of humor. You might also become a fan of Jimmy Buffett, even if you aren't a parrot head. You'll get a kick out of the names of new 55-plus communities inspired by his songs and laid-back lifestyle. Finally, I'm most excited for you to read my brand new chapter, Corporate Creativity. Even if you don't work for a big company, you'll enjoy reading how companies from LinkedIn to McDonald's are using creative names around the office to add personality to everything from cafeterias to conference rooms. You'll devour those names faster than a bowl of Fleetwood mac and cheese. Honestly, that's the name of a meeting room. Enjoy Awesome 2.0. Alexandra Watkins. P.S. Please don't whiz by the preface. It has your name written all over it. Preface. Pop quiz. When someone sees your new brand name, how do you want them to react? A. Exclaim, "I freaking love it!" B. Struggle to explain it as if they're reading hieroglyphics. C. Go back to looking at their phone. D. Throw up a little bit in their mouth. Obviously, you should be shooting for choice A, for awesome. Your brand name makes a critical first impression, even more than your shoes. How many times will someone see, say, or hear the name of your brand in its lifetime? Do the math. The number of impressions is incalculable. No other investment you'll make in your business will last longer or get used more than your name. Getting it wrong can have painful consequences. Just like jumping into a relationship before you really get to know someone, you may not discover the faults of a poorly chosen name right away. You'll be too caught up in everything else you need to do to launch a new product or company. It won't be until after you've started to build a future together that you realize your name has issues, and you'll be forced to find ways to justify it. Like the bizarrely named baby clothing company, Species, spelled S-P-E-E-S-E-E-S. Here's how they explained the idiotic spelling.
S-P-E-E-S-E-E-S is the way a baby would spell species if a baby could spell.
Really? Really? I don't want you to make a decision you will forever regret. Luckily, when you read this book, you will no longer be oblivious to the obvious. The eye-opening stories here will help you avoid countless unforeseen naming pitfalls. You'll read what happened to companies that thought they had a creative name, but later realized it was a mistake. Like Bought, spelled B-A-W-T-E, whose name, a bastardized spelling of the word bought, B-O-U-G-H-T, could also be misheard as the word bot, B-O-T, both by humans and by robots. Or American Scrap Metal, which may have had its domain name, AmericanScrapMetal.com, emblazoned on everything from trucks to t-shirts, before they noticed it could be read as Americans Crap Metal. As the chief executive boss lady of the naming firm Eat My Words, I've been involved in hundreds of naming projects over the past 2 decades. This book is packed with the most important information that you need to know. I sure wish I had known everything in the book when I was starting out. You'll learn how to create love-at-first-sight names that are so awesome that people will want to buy merchandise featuring it. Imagine that. Someone paying you to advertise your brand. I'll show you how to come up with dozens of creative ideas. Coming up with names will no longer be frustrating or daunting. It will be easy and exciting. By simply following my framework, you will succeed beyond your imagination. If you want more assurance that this book will help you create awesome names, consider the story of Janice Pappas, an SAT math tutor who read, "Hello, my name is Awesome." She studied the book cover to cover, then took a crack at the ultimate dream job challenge, found on the eatmywords.com website. Countless amateurs have taken the test over the past 14 years, with only a handful being good enough to get hired. Statistically, Janice had a better chance of winning the Hunger Games. I rarely see any new names that melt my butter. Janice aced the test, submitting some of the most delightful names I have ever seen. She now works for Eat My Words. Sweet. This book works for everyone because it's based on a clear set of best practices and a proven process. It's easy to follow because I break down all the information into fun-sized brain candy. It's meant to be devoured. And it has been. The reviews on Goodreads and Amazon prove it. Unfortunately, despite an Amazon review titled, "A Very Dope Book," my publisher refused to let me rename this updated edition, "Hello, My Name is Dope." Considering how many times I've named cannabis companies, this really killed my buzz. Speaking of weed, creating names does not involve doing bong hits, nor is it a science. Yet naming firms spout ridiculous jargon about verbal identity engineering, rigorous methodologies, and computational linguistics. Does any of that sound even remotely imaginative? Consumers don't fall in love with brand names created by artificial intelligence, linguistic voodoo, or mangling the alphabet. Mechanical name mutations don't resonate with humans because unfamiliar names lack the critical feel-good factor. That is the emotional connection we crave. We connect with the most powerful brand names because they are based on familiar concepts we understand and appreciate. Obsession perfume, kryptonite locks, Hollywood hair. These kinds of names speak volumes. As an advertising copywriter at Ogilvy & Mather, I learned how to use words to capture the attention of consumers. Just as an arresting print ad headline will turn heads, generate buzz, and spark sales, brand names can have the same magical effect. So get ready to be a magician. This is my bag of tricks. Introduction. Hello, my name is Alexandra. Sounds simple enough, but strangers often butcher my name. Alexandria. Alexia, Alexa, and much to my annoyance, the manly version, Alexander. What about your first and last name? Are they tricky to spell? Difficult to pronounce? Hard to remember? This trifecta of trouble is rampant among brand names. Zobni, which is spelled X-O-B-N-I. Sir La Table, which is usually pronounced Sir La Table. Iams, Flicker, Saucony, which is spelled S-A-U-C-O-N-Y, and Yukanuba, which is spelled E-U-K-A-N-U-B-A. Ugh. Those are just a handful of the head-scratchers consumers struggle with. But unlike the name you were born with or married into, these companies chose to start out with names that are easily bungled. At the time, they may have thought they were being clever. But even after being in business for years, they find themselves having to explain the name, how to spell it, how to pronounce it. what it means. Anytime you have to make excuses for your name, you're apologizing for it. And when you apologize for your name, your brand is devalued. I'm going to prevent you from making any of these mistakes. Amazon, Coca-Cola, Disney, Frito-Lay, Google, Xerox, and other big brands hire my firm because they have discovered what I have known for years. Names that resonate most with consumers are delightfully unexpected, yet easy to understand. We instantly get them, like a snappy punchline. No one wants to feel clueless. Have you figured out what Zobni means yet? I've filled every page of this book with practical, firsthand knowledge. There are no wasted words. You won't find any junk science, branding jargon, or linguistic mumbo-jumbo. And I haven't included the etymology of famous brand names. Sure, those stories are interesting, but this is a how-to guide, not a history book. My techniques for coming up with memorable brand names can be learned by anyone. Even the most uptight actuary can unleash their inner creative beast to come up with some terrific names that everyone can spell, pronounce, and understand. I don't believe in creating names that are unfamiliar, unrecognizable, or unintelligible. Who cares that the name Hiranyagarbha means cosmic intelligence in ancient Sanskrit? The most powerful names get noticed, get buzz, and get sales because they connect with consumers on an emotional level, making us feel good. Traditional naming firms have yet to figure this out. This is how I was able to make a name for myself. When I started out, I worked as a professional namer for big branding firms like Landor and Interbrand. It baffled me that instead of hiring conceptual writers from advertising to create names, they recruited people from academia. What can a degree in theoretical linguistics possibly teach anyone about making emotional connections with consumers? You'll find no pedagogical examples in this book, just dozens of true stories about real names. The good, the bad, and the so bad I gave them an award. I am not afraid to name names. I'll break down the brainstorming process by walking you through how to come up with dozens of creative name ideas using my most trusted tools and treasure troves. Before we jump into brainstorming name ideas, you'll learn how to objectively evaluate names using the Smile and Scratch test, a checklist based on my philosophy. A name should make you smile instead of scratch your head. Smile. The five qualities of a super sticky name. Suggestive. Evokes something about your brand. Memorable. Makes an association with the familiar. Imagery. Aids memory through evocative visuals. Legs. Lends itself to a theme for extended mileage. Emotional. Moves people. Scratch. The seven deal breakers. Spelling challenged. Looks like a typo. Copycat. Resembles competitors' names. Restrictive. Limits future growth. Annoying. Seems forced. Frustrates customers. Tame. Feels flat, descriptive, uninspired. Curse of knowledge. Speaks only to insiders. Hard to pronounce. Confuses and distances customers. This filter is a no-brainer, right? Yet you'd be surprised how many brand names fail this test. How does the name Zobni do? Everything in this book is that clear. And by the time you finish the last chapter, you will have the knowledge you need to create awesome names on your own. Some of my colleagues think I'm crazy for sharing my secret sauce. They think that I may be cannibalizing my business by showing amateurs how to do what I get paid the big bucks for. I can assure you that since the book was originally published, it has not put me out of the name game. But it has put me out of my misery by helping prevent bad names from happening to good brands. Yours truly, Alexandra Watkins. Oh, if you're still trying to decipher Zobni, it's inbox spelled backward. Don't worry, no one else figured it out either. Chapter 1. Smile. The five qualities of a super sticky name. Think of five brand names that made you smile the first time you heard them. My Fab Five: Chubby Hubby, Scrub Daddy, Nerd Wax, Bedhead, and Super Evil Megacorp. We appreciate it when names surprise us, entertain us, and give us a happy little jolt of dopamine. Names that make us smile are infectious. They are the ones we talk about, tweet, and repeat. Why? We enjoy making others smile too. I relish the grin on someone's face when they ask the name of my own company, eat my words, or about the names I've created over the years. It's impossible not to smile when someone says Gringo Lingo, Church of Cupcakes, or Thank God It's Coffee. In case you skipped the introduction, the Smile and Scratch name evaluation test is based on my philosophy: a name should make you smile instead of scratch your head. SMILE is an acronym for the five qualities of a great name. SCRATCH is the flip side, which I cover in the next chapter. SMILE, the five qualities of a super sticky name. Suggestive, memorable, imagery, legs, emotional. Ideally, your name should have all these attributes. Suggestive. Evokes something about your brand. A name can't be expected to say everything, but it can suggest something about your brand. Not in an overly obvious way, but in a way that activates the imagination. Have you heard of the Impossible Burger? Fans swear that the plant-based Frankenmeat made in a lab.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.